beach station. Alight here to enjoy our golden beaches, a wide selection of F&B outlets, and exciting attractions. Please stay.
I'm now in Sentosa. I'm going to go find some unique sites to go see today. It is raining a bit, so I'm not sure whether we get to see it because it's a bit of an outdoor space. But yeah, we'll try it out anyhow. It's supposed to be a World War II historic site, so I thought I'd go see that because it's quite interesting. And hopefully I get to see you and show you guys. Siloso Point. I'm supposed to go see the Siloso Fort, and it rained just now, so slightly wet. So behind me is the elevator to go up to the fort, and we are gonna go up after this and then go see the fort. So yeah, come along with us. The Fort Siloso lift entrance. So we go up the lift and go all the way up and walk all the way to the end. And we go to the Fort Siloso. And let's go up now. Come on. All the way up. Alright, we're at top of the elevator lift place. And we got great views from up here, and you can see most of Sentosa and some parts of Singapore from here. And we are apparently 36.3 meters up, and this is how, oh my god, the view looks like. Ooh, wow.
And directing the fire of the guns.
We're still at Fort Siloso, and behind me is the museum and some of the gun embattlements and stuff behind me. Now in front of me are the barrels. Yeah, as you can see. So I think along the way further down there's the surrender reenactment and all these things, so I'll show you later.
Intendants, as well as to protect the harbor from attack by sea. December 8, 1941, Japan turned its sights to Malaya and Singapore. Three simultaneous actions were launched, their intent to surprise, shock, and croak.
Yamashita laid down his terms, unconditional surrender. General Percival, taken aback,
a slim figure in white metal uniform walked briskly to the hospital chamber and sat down.
We are done at Fort Siloso. We went to see the whole thing, most of it at least. Saw all the gun embattlements and the background stories, how Singapore was captured, the whole Malaya was captured. Then we went to see how people lived afterwards, you know, how they were treated, the money, the currency, torture, and some of the life of people around back then. Then we went to the surrender chambers, I think, where it reenacted the surrender by the first British at the old Ford factory. Then subsequently the surrender by the Japanese, and then they had with the audio recording there. So that was interesting. A lot of guns and a lot of history shown to us, and now we are off to our next place. All right. Okay, now we're at our next destination. We are at Gardens by the Bay, and we're gonna go see the famous gardens and all these things, the famous Marina Bay set. So it's standing quite high next to us, and there it is. So this is the Chinese garden. Some waterfalls, so it's quite chilly inside here. Yeah, so woohoo! I see. Very refreshing. I'm scared as hell. Just came out from the first walkway. It's too high. Too scary for me. I thought there were no roller coasters inside this garden thing. Apparently they did. Yeah. So you can see behind me all the walkway. Yeah. Alright, it's too high, too high. I'm afraid of heights. Okay. I'm on the treetop walk. This one I'm able to attempt. I think it's not too high, so less scary, but still. So you can see behind me the gardens on this level, so it's not bad. I was there up here just now. That was too scary. Okay, now I am in the flower dome, and it's got different types of flowers, and you can see behind me this all this type of flowers which we are prohibited from touching. Yes, okay. Furry one. And the rest of the garden. Thank you.